Hi, I'm so glad you could come. Yeah, I feel like it's been a while. Yeah. Well, sit down. Make yourself at home. I made you a tea in one of my fox mugs. I think they're so cute with the little tail and their little ears sticking out. I really, really like them. I only just got them recently. Yeah, you like them too? I thought that you would. I know that you like foxes the same as me. And I thought this was really cute, so the tea, it's dirty chai, yeah, so it's chai tea, but it has espresso in the bag, so you don't have to make espresso and tea, you just do one, and yeah, the espresso is like instant espresso, I guess, so it's really convenient and it's really easy. Yeah, it's really good. I love it. And I probably have maybe like 20, 25 different teas, but I think that this is my favorite one. It's a little spicy and a little just a little bitter from the espresso, which I think is nice. Yeah, you like it? Yeah, it's really good. Okay, so what I thought that we could do today is put together one of these little craft kits that I got. They look like this. They're little houses. I've put them together before, but I thought of you when I looked at them, and I thought that you might like to put one together with me. Okay, great, great. I'm really glad because I know they're a little, maybe a little bit funny, but I really like them. So I actually have maybe like 20 or 25 different ones of these. I know. I'm kind of a craft kit hoarder. I just think they were so cute and I couldn't like pick between which one that I wanted. So anyway, I ended up with a whole bunch. So I'm not gonna show you 25 of them because then we would be here for the rest of our lives. So I just pulled like three that I thought that you would like. And then you can pick which one if you prefer one over the other, and if you don't like any of them, I can pull some other ones from the shelf and you can pick from those instead, but I tried to pick ones that I thought that you would like. Okay, so this is the first one, and they say 3D World Style, Welcome to the USA. I think that the idea behind these is that you would pick them up places you had traveled to remind you of where you had been, or as like a little memento. I don't do a lot of traveling. I'm sort of a homebody, I guess, and I don't really travel. So I don't get them because I travel. I just get them because I like little houses. So I hope that you like the little houses too because I think they're really cute. So this one is American. Obviously, I've been to an American restaurant before, so this is one of few ones that you could make the argument that I've been there. But yeah, this one has like a little burger and a little fries on the roof, and I think it's really cute. And it says, "How to keep balance between time and delicacy. Come back to the original home of fast food restaurants in the world. You can get the different style with the same name." As you can probably tell, these were translated not so well. And I think it's really funny. They're made in Shanto, China. I don't know if that's how you say it, but so they're translated into English and not very well all the time. But they're very, very, very cute, and I really love them. So anyway, so this is the American one. And then I picked this one. I thought that you might like it because it's Japanese, and I know that you have some interest in Japan, so I thought that you might like this one. It's Osaka Castle. I thought it was really cool. Yeah, I really liked how it was up on these bricks or rocks. I thought that they were really, really cool, and I liked all the roofs, so I thought that you might like this one. And this one doesn't say anything on it for whatever reason. It has no description, so But yeah, I thought this one was really cute. And then the third option that you might like is this one. It's the British Tea House, British flavor. It's actually a bridal tea house. I don't know about a bridal tea house. Is that a thing in the US? I don't know. Doesn't sound like a thing that I've heard of, but I thought that you might like this since like we both like tea and you know, we're drinking tea right now, so I thought that you might like the bridal tea house. I thought it was really cute. And it says, ease your busy life, enjoy your tea time, warm your heart in bridal tea house. So I thought it was really cute. And then all of them have like this little complexity rating, and it says 3 out of 5 complexity for all of them. But to me, the Osaka castle looks more difficult. Yeah, I think it looks a little bit harder, but it's supposed to be the same. So whatever one you want should be the same difficulty. You want to try the burger one? Okay, yeah, I really like that one too. The American restaurant with the little burger and the fries. It is really cute. Yeah, it is. I really like it. Okay, so let me just open it up and I'll show you sort of what you get on the inside. Hopefully we don't need any scissors because I didn't get any out. I think it should be okay. Let's see. It's a little sticky. Let's try. It's coming. Slowly but surely. There we go. Alright, that's pretty good. Alright. Okay, so I'll put that over there. That's the box. This is what it comes inside. It's a little plastic pack, and then it has the directions and then the little boards. It's sort of made out of like little foam boards. Yeah, like little foam, I think foam core is what you would call that. Yeah, so that's what's on the inside. We can open it up and I'll show you. We need to wrap any pieces back up. I'm gonna have a little sip of tea. Okay. So here we have the directions for the fast food restaurant. Yeah. Open it up. So like I said, it's not made in the US, but it's okay because the directions are pictures. And so we can follow them, and actually it's easier for me, I think, to follow the pictures because sometimes with text directions I get a little bit mixed up or confused about, I don't know, what it means. It's probably just a personal problem. So we'll follow these pictures to build it. And there's actually a bunch of text on the back that explains like the idea behind the restaurant. Except, you know, it's the perception of the American restaurant from Shanto, I think, Shanto, China. So, it can be a little bit funny if you want me to read it. You want to read it? Okay. When fast food restaurants blossom everywhere in the world, American people still keep being keen on fast food. Different kinds of fast food restaurants emerge endlessly, and people can see a fast food restaurant in a few steps. That is true. I guess you can't argue with that. It is said that fast food business is developing with the prosperities of auto culture. I don't know what that means. Where there was a highway, there were cars and fast food restaurants accompanied with gas stations and rest stations. Oh, okay. I mean, that makes sense. That makes sense. The catering culture from Europe took its roots in America. No matter sandwiches from UK or chips from Germany, they all accord people's catering needs of speediness and clearness. Clearness. There is nothing. I like this headline. There is nothing. There is nothing. There is nothing can be more classical than hot dog. It's very true. It is said that the inventor of hot dog is a German. He wanted to sell German sausage in America, but he cannot offer enough knives and forks for clients. Then he changed to offer gloves, whereas it was difficult to wash the gloves, and the gloves were easily to be picked up by clients. Picked up the gloves? Oh dear. At last, an idea burst upon him to get a sausage with a loaf of bread. In this way, people can taste the delicious food without getting their hands dirty. Oh, okay, well, that's true. Originally, there were many names for this kind of sausage. One kind is, Dachshund? I don't know German. Dachshund sausage? One day, when a cartoonist, Ted Dorgan, was drawing a peddler in baseball field, he forgot the spelling of Dachshund, so that he used hot dog instead of it. Unexpectedly, hot dog spread like wildfire, and it finally became the only name for this kind of sausage with a loaf of bread. Wow, I have never heard of such a thing before, that they know something in Shanto, China that we don't know here. At least, I didn't know that, so that's really funny. Anyway, that's just a bit of humor. We can, get into the building. I'm going to, punch out some of these little things. So you have to punch out the little pieces, and then we can build them according to the directions. But, you just want to watch? Okay. You can just watch, so I'll just put the directions here, and, you can just watch me build it and drink your tea. Yeah. Okay. So it looks like the first piece we need is number 2, and that's this one here. So I'm gonna punch it out. Alright. And then we also need number 11. Let's see, where's number 11? Oh, what's this? Oh, I think this is a... Oh, it's a postcard. Again, I think the idea is that you would use these for traveling. So if you were to travel to the US and you want to send a postcard of a fake house, you can do that. That would be really funny to send this to someone. Let's see, where is 11? Here we go, here's 11. And we need 7 is the big base part. What's that? Oh, okay, you can see it's like the checkered floor. So it'll take a little while for me to punch out these things. Why don't you tell me what you've been up to lately? Oh, really? Yeah? That's really cool. I haven't really been up to much, to be honest. You know me, I'm kind of a homebody. And, I've mostly been watching Netflix, I guess. And, I haven't been doing very much. I've been a little bit tired. A little bit, maybe needing a little bit of relaxation time, a little bit more than usual. Yeah, so I've been a little low energy, but that's okay. That's not really a problem. Sometimes you just need to relax for a while, and you just need some time to recharge. Yeah. I just have to pop out all these little tabs out of the floor. And Some of them are a little tricky to get to because they're really tiny. Yeah. So have you been doing a lot of craft projects recently? A little bit? Yeah. I guess I've been mostly crocheting. Yeah, that's what I do the most. I think it's really relaxing and what have I made? I've been making mandalas, I guess is what you call them, where there's like rings of different patterns and colors. I really like making them. They're really fun to me. I like to see how the patterns come out, and when you pick the colors, you never really know exactly what it's gonna look like in the end. So it's really fun to see how it turns out. So maybe that's what I like about it. It's a little bit more exploratory than other kinds of crochet where you know exactly like what it's going to look like in the end. I like to sort of leave it up to whim a little bit and just sort of see which colors seem good to me at the time. Yeah. So I think we're making the little desk, like the little checkout counter, I guess is what you would call it. Well, I punched these out and then I didn't keep track of the numbers. I think I punched too many out at one time. But I'm pretty sure this one is 11. Oh, there we go. And this goes this way. Oh, I think it goes this way. Goes up inside this. Gonna push. There we go. So, you've been watching Stranger Things 3? Is that what you said? Yeah, Stranger Things Season 3. And you like it? Yeah? Good. Yeah, I finished it. I watched it a little bit fast. Because I really liked this season. I liked this season better than the second season. I was a little bit, worried about the show after the second season because I was a little bit disappointed. I know a lot of people really liked it, but to me it didn't really do much for me personally. So, I really liked this third season. It reminded me of the things that I liked more about the first season. And here we have the little checkout counter. Yeah, it's really cute. Okay, so now what are we making? This one, I think. Silly me, because I did not check the numbers. I punched out them from the foam thing, and then I didn't keep track of which was which number, so now I have to kind of guess a little bit. But it's not too hard, because like I said, there are pictures, so we should do okay. We should be okay. Maybe I'm ambitious because I don't know where this one goes. Spoke too soon. Okay, let's wait on that for a second. Let's look at this one. This goes this way. There we go. And this must be number 8. So it goes here. Okay. And then this goes like this. Let me see. Yeah.
I think that is right. It goes here. I think it's like more of the checkout. Here we go. Yeah, I think it's more of the checkout. And I left a couple of tabs here by accident in the top, so I'm gonna have to punch those out. They're gonna be trapped inside here forever. That's okay. Doesn't have to be perfect. Really, it's just a silly little thing to do together. It doesn't have to be perfect. Oh, now it rattles. Oh, the little thing came out. Okay, doesn't have to rattle anymore. Okay, so now I think that this part goes around there. I'm gonna use this to punch out a little part that won't come. There we go. Some little nubs are still in there. What else have I watched? Well, after I watched Stranger Things season 3, I watched The Sinner season 2. Yeah, I didn't watch it on TV. I don't actually have cable or satellite or anything. I only watch things on Netflix and Hulu. So I had to wait until it got on one of those, and I forget which one it's on. But yeah, I had to wait until it got on there. So, did I like it? Yeah, I did. I really liked the second season. It kept my attention. I was really, like, intrigued. I think that it was not as good as the first season. I think that there were some loose ends that I felt like weren't tied up as well in the second season. So, okay, here we have the little counter. It's getting bigger. I think it's really cute. Okay, so now that's all the pieces that I have punched out so far, so now we need some more pieces. Alright, we need 18 and 17. 18, where are you? 18. Oh, there's a whole bunch of 18s. And the 17s. I think we're making a whole bunch of little booths. Alright, so we don't need that. Use this little thing to punch out those little nubby holes there. Alrighty. Then, so all of these little red bits are like the booths, so we're gonna just build bunch of tiny little booths. Yeah. Just stick that in there. This one. The last one, and okay, so now we can put the booths into the little restaurant. This is one of the things that I like about these kits, because they have like these little inside parts, even though they have like an outside. So they didn't really have to do that, to put that that much detail in. It's nice that they do make such a detailed little model, and they're really cheap and just fun little things, but the attention to detail I think is really nice, and they always go together really, really well. Yeah, they go together really easily, and they don't take any glue, so they're really casual and nice for really anyone. Oh, it looks like there should be two more boots here, so we should find those. They're hiding on a separate little board. Alrighty, let's put those little guys together. Maybe we should get rid of some of this little paper debris. Make little, you can make like a little maraca out of these. Yeah. Oh, okay, we should get them out of the way, making a bigger mess. Okay. So here's our little house, not a house. A restaurant. I actually, I can't eat at burger restaurants because I have food allergies, and I can't really eat out most places because it's really hard to, it's really hard to, get the cook surfaces clean enough, even when the restaurants can try, really hard, but I'm really, really sensitive. And I get really, really, really sick, so yeah. Yeah, that's why we don't go out to eat very often, because I don't know, I feel, just dropping stuff. I feel uncomfortable, I guess, to try to eat out and then get sick, and then we'd have to go home, and it wouldn't be a fun time for either of us, so that's why I usually try to, like, cook dinner for you, so we don't have to worry about that. So I can't really eat at, a burger place. I haven't eaten at a burger place in, probably about 11 years, because I used to get sick, and I didn't know why. Look at these little boots, they're so, so cute. Yeah, they're so cute. Okay, I suspect that we're gonna make the little tables now. So, let's see. Okay, 4 and 1 are the number of the tables. Here's 1, 1, 1. There's 1, 1. Ooh. Here's 2, 1, and 3 of 1, and now we need 4 for the table top. There's 1, 4, 2, 4s, and last one, 3, 3, 4s. There we go. 3 floors. 3 floors. Getting tongue-tied with all of these numbers. Yeah, you know, numbers are not my strong suit, per se. Although, somehow I think, that I've actually gotten better at numbers, as I've gotten older, even though you would think it would be the other way. Maybe it's because, when I was little and I had to do numbers for school, that I feel a lot more stressed about it, about getting it right, and they don't want to look stupid, I guess, and so I tried a little bit too hard and made it harder on myself, and then I made it hard for me to do the math, because I had some anxiety about it more than made it easy, so yeah, made it extra hard. So anyway, we're gonna put these little tables in here. Push, go in. Oh, there you go. You don't want to push too hard because you don't want to break it. This little table there. And this last little table. Push. Come on. Okay. Yeah, I always talk to my projects. I know that's silly because they can't understand you, but it helps me to think through what I'm doing when I push on them. And then I say, push. I don't know. I think it's just for me. Maybe it helps me to concentrate. Let's see, what is this little guy? I think this is, like a little, like little sodas, I think. Like a little ice chest. I don't know if you can see it. I can barely see it. I almost need, like, a magnifying glass. Alright, I'm gonna put this in here. Go on in. Ooh, go in, little buddy. You don't want to push too hard on the foam because it can break pretty easy, but that's pretty good. So there's the little booth. It's so cute in this little ice box. I don't know, little drink refrigerator. Yeah, it's so cute. Oh, it's squeaking a little bit. Okay, so now, let's see. What are we doing? Oh, looks like we're gonna do the outside, like the big part, the wall part. So, we need number 6 is here. Oh, it's such a big piece. I'll show you, it's so big. Look how big this piece is. It's like the whole building. Okay. I'm gonna use this little guy to pop out these little nubs. I really like popping little things out. Whenever we get like a new board game, I always like to pop out the little tokens or whatever. It's very satisfying. Okay, so those little guys are out. And now we have these big windows. All these big windows pop out. Pop. Any of those little bits. Okay. So, we'll bend the walls. Get out some of those little nubs. They want to hang out in there. And they don't want to come out. Okay. So now, this little guy goes right on the front. Right, choop. Oh, missed a couple little nubs. Choop. Alrighty. Close that up. Choop. Okay. And this one closes like this way. I think it's like the back wall. Yeah, there you go. Oh wow. This back wall has like all these little decorations, like vending machines and like the menu. You can see back here. It's so cute. Yeah, the details are so nice on these. They really put a lot of time into it, and I think it's really nice. They're not just like thrown together. They're really like thoughtful designs. Okay, so now it looks like we're gonna make the awnings, which is cool. I like the little stripes, they're really cute. Pop those out. Excuse me, I've been having a little bit of allergies. Yeah, I think there's a lot of, I think it's tree, I think it's tree pollen. Yeah, there's a lot of that. Bend the little awnings. Doesn't really, oh, it goes that way. Okay, I was gonna say, it doesn't really show very much. They're just gonna stick straight on, like that way. Oh, easy. Don't bend. Alright. Yeah, see, I have to talk to myself when I do crafts. It helps me to concentrate. It's silly. Some of these are a little bit different. Two of them are a little bit different from the other ones. I'm not sure. Not sure why. The stripes are, different colors. I don't know if you can really tell, but they're not exactly the same. Maybe, the side ones and the front ones are different. I don't know. I think I'm missing one though. Oh, here it is. Okay, there we go. Gotta keep all of your parts organized when you do these projects, or else you can lose. Ooh, you can lose the stuff that you need. See, this is why I have to tell myself to be careful, or else I start to break things. Careful. I don't have very, very steady hands. I have a little bit of shaky hands and not really very good motor skills, maybe. I have really, really bad handwriting. You know, you've seen my handwriting, and it's really, it's embarrassing for an adult person. It's not very good handwriting. So, yeah, I don't know why. But the little fine motor skills are a little bit hard for me. Alrighty, there we go. So there are our little front awnings. They're so cute. Yeah. And then there's the side awnings, which is, I guess, like the drive-in window, maybe? Yeah. Push, 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 push. There we go. Now I have the side awnings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 awnings. It's so cute. Okay. Now what we're going to do. What is 13? Let's see. Oh, I think it's stairs. Yeah. And they go up to. Is it stairs? Oh, yeah, there we go. I just had it the wrong way. And, yeah, so then we just added these little, this little staircase right here up to the top. And now it wants us to add the ground. The ground is, I guess, cobblestones, maybe? These are like cobblestones? Yeah. Little bit fancier than you would typically see at an American burger place, I think. Where'd my little thing go? Oh, here we go. I need this thing to punch out the little nubs.
those off of there. Alright. Get that. Okay. There we go. So this whole thing has to go on there. This is probably the trickiest part of putting these little houses together, because it's a lot of little tabs to get in at the same time, and this is where you have to be very careful, and it's better if you have steadier hands, or I don't know, more motor skills than I have, because I find this part a little bit more difficult. Go in there. Yeah, there we go. And this one. Oh, this one got folded over. There we go. There we go, it's on it's on the ground now. Alright. Now I suspect that we need to make the roof. And here it is. There we go. Here's the roof. The roof, and we'll put it on. I think it can go either way. I don't think that it matters which direction. Beautiful. Here it is with its little roof, and now it's missing the burger and fries on the top. My favorite part. Okay. Oh, and also they always have I'll show you. They always have this little sign that goes in the front, and then on the back it says 2. I don't know if you can really see that. It doesn't really, it's hard to see, but it says 2 there. I think it's like you're supposed to gift it to somebody. I don't really know, to be honest. I just buy them because I think they're really cute. So we can put that on. That's second to last. And then the last thing is the burger and fries. Alright. Here it is. Ta-da! So here it is, our little restaurant. And the booths are still in there, but it's really hard to see them. But I think that it's so cute. And the back doesn't really have anything, but you're never gonna look at the back. And you can still see the floor on the underside. But, yeah, you'll just display it like this. Do you want to take it? Oh, yeah, you can keep it. Yeah, you can keep it, for sure. Like I said, I think I have, like, 20 of these already built. And then I have, like, 20 more of them that aren't built. Yeah. So if you want to build another one with me sometime, just let me know. And we can build it together. You can come over and we can do this again. Yeah, just let me know. Anytime. Yeah. Okay, yeah, here you go. You can take it. I'm so happy for you. It's so cute. Okay? Alright, well, thank you for coming and building it with me. It was so, so fun. And I hope that you'll come back and we can do it again. Yeah? Okay. Alright, well, bye. Have a good day.